Hey, welcome to the Electrical Project channel. A while ago, I became fascinated by atomic clocks and their incredible precision. I wondered, can I achieve that level of precision in my lab? It's not just cool, but also useful for calibrating various devices. Unfortunately, atomic clocks are very expensive, so buying one is not always an option. However, we can still use atomic clocks without owning them. They are flying above us all the time in the GPS satellites. Today I'll show you a simple yet powerful way to calibrate your oven controlled crystal oscillator OCXO using just an oscilloscope and a GPS module. No need for fancy GPS disciplined oscillators here. Join me as I manually replicate what GPS disciplined oscillators do automatically, giving you an inside look into how GPSDOs work. We'll also verify our calibration results by comparing them to my DIY GPSDO. Let's get started. Here is the OCXO that I bought on AliExpress. It's used, but it works well. And here is a little circuit that I built to use it and calibrate it. Everything here is quite simple. We have a 7805 voltage regulator. Here it is. It's used to provide stable 5 volts to power the OCXO. Let's take a closer look at the circuit. First, let's talk about the pins that the OCXO has. It has a ground pin and a VCC pin for power. It also has an output pin that provides 10 MHz. That's the frequency that we're going to calibrate today. Additionally, it has a pin to adjust the frequency. By adjusting the voltage at this pin in the range of 0 to 4 volts, it allows us to accurately tune it to 10 MHz. Practically, I found that at 2 volts I can get that perfect 10 MHz frequency. Here I decided to use TL431, which works like a Zener diode and provides a voltage reference for the OCXO. By connecting it like this to the potentiometer, we can get a stable 2.5 volt voltage reference. By turning the trimmer potentiometer, we can adjust the voltage between 0 to 2.5 volts, which is fine since the calibrated frequency is achieved at 2 volts anyway. So I don't need the whole 0 to 4 volts range. Some OCXOs may actually provide a voltage reference on one of their pins, but mine doesn't. Let's connect the OCXO with the 7805 voltage regulator to 9 volts DC and give it a few minutes to warm up. Now let's calibrate the OCXO by adjusting the trimmer potentiometer. But to do so we need a reference frequency. That's where our GPS modules come in. In the UCenter app on my computer, I use these settings. So the GPS module provides 1 MHz. I set 1 MHz instead of 10 MHz because at 10 MHz, the GPS module provides a very confusing signal due to the way internal frequency synthesis is done. But we can still easily reference 1 MHz to 10 MHz with the oscilloscope. First, let's connect the oscilloscope to the PPS pin on the GPS module. As you can see on the oscilloscope, we have our 1 MHz reference signal on the yellow trace. The signal looks good and clean, but in reality it has a lot of jitter, which we will see later by comparing it to the OCXO. Now let's connect the 10 MHz output of the OCXO to the oscilloscope. Now let's zoom it in. Here you can see two things. First, the blue trace jumps from side to side. That's jitter. It may look like the 10 MHz signal from the OCXO has jitter, but it's actually the signal from the GPS module that has jitter. It appears like that because the oscilloscope triggers on the signal from the GPS module and uses it as a reference. The second thing that we notice is that the signal moves to the left, which is exactly what we are interested in. Remember that the signal from the GPS module, the yellow trace, can be traced back to the atomic clock on the GPS satellite. So if our OCXO was actually producing 10 MHz, those two signals would not move relative to each other. For each period of the yellow trace, we should have exactly 10 periods of the blue trace. But because the OCXO produces a slightly lower frequency, it looks like the signal from it moves to the left. Our goal is to calibrate the OCXO so both signals don't move relative to each other. So let's do it. If I overdo it like I did here, the signal starts to move to the right, which means that the frequency of the OCXO is higher than 10 MHz. Our goal is to adjust it so those signals don't move relative to each other. It may be a bit tricky, especially with the jitter that we observe. Turning on the persistent display on my scope could help me better see how the signals move relative to each other. It may take time before we can achieve that perfect alignment and no movement. Keep an eye on it for a few minutes to ensure that the calibration is precise. Seems like right now I calibrated it close enough. Now let's turn off the persistent display on the scope. Now I want to show you that our calibration is actually accurate. To do so, I want to compare our calibrated signal with a DIY GPSDO that I built a while ago. So let's connect the probe to my DIY GPSDO and turn on the third channel, the red trace on the scope. A GPS disciplined oscillator is a device that constantly performs this calibration automatically. Let's trigger our scope on the blue channel, the signal from our calibrated OCXO, and use it as a reference. Now we can turn off the yellow channel. As you can see, the two signals agree with each other and don't move relative to each other. Of course, we may see some drift over time, but I think that's a very good and impressive result. To make it more fun, let me turn off the GPSDO and then turn it back on to see how after a while both signals will agree with each other again. I disconnect the power and I reconnect it. The green LED means that the GPSDO doesn't have a lock to GPS. Now we need to wait a few minutes while the GPSDO tunes its frequency. Let's wait. After a while, we can see that the green LED starts to turn off from time to time, which means that the GPSDO is almost ready to provide us with a 10 MHz reference. If everything is done correctly, both frequencies should agree with each other. As you can see, the signals move back and forth, but after a while they both gonna agree again. Now, as you can see, they don't move relative to each other. So, as you can see, we successfully calibrated the OCXO using the GPS module, and the resulting frequency matches my DIY GPSDO, confirming that this method works effectively. That's great, but what if we need a different frequency? For that, we can use this simple and inexpensive clock module. The only catch is that we need to inject a 10 MHz reference signal into it. Here is my modification. I scratched the PCB to create an additional trace for the signal and soldered an SMA connector. The original crystal oscillator had to be removed. And I terminated the input with a 47 ohms resistor. According to the datasheet, the signal here needs to be 1 volt peak to peak. To comply with datasheet, I'm adding a 220 ohms resistor at the OCXO's output. Together with the 47 ohms SMD resistor, it forms a voltage divider, which should give us a signal close to 1 volt peak to peak. Something like this. Now the 10 MHz signal can be converted into whatever frequency I need. Let's compare the reference 10 MHz from the OCXO with the output. As you can see, we have 10 MHz in and 10 MHz out. The cool part is that I can now adjust it even by 1 Hz, higher or lower. Or I can generate other frequencies like 50 MHz. Or even 100 MHz, all of which are referenced to the atomic clock on the GPS satellite. I'm planning to use all of this with my DIY GPSDO, but as we saw today, a GPSDO isn't mandatory. You can achieve accurate results by calibrating directly with the GPS module. To give you some insights into how GPSDOs work, I want to show you how my GPSDO achieves synchronization. My DIY GPSDO is quite simple and uses a PLL, phase locked loop. The GPS module generates a 100 kHz signal, while the OCXO generates a 10 MHz signal, which is divided by 100 to also produce 100 kHz. These two signals are then compared using a phase detector. The output from the phase detector is filtered with a basic RC filter and then fed to the adjustment pin of the OCXO. Over time, the voltage at the OCXO's adjustment pin slowly adjusts until both signals are perfectly in phase and as a result have the same frequency. The RC filter ensures that the voltage at the OCXO's adjustment pin changes slowly, which cancels out the jitter from the GPS module. Essentially, the GPS module just gradually guides the OCXO using the phase-locked loop. That's everything for today. I hope you find this as interesting as I did. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.